Hello, everybody. Good morning, United States, Florida, South Carolina, North Carolina, California, from the East Coast to the West Coast. Good morning or good afternoon, wherever you are. This is Nancy here in Florida, and this is Road Download. My signal in my car is not so good, so I tried to go out and see if I can get a better signal. And today is really cold here in Florida. It's about 37 degrees, and I just want to get a good signal out here so I can share Road Download and be with you, with all of you, and let the Word of God be sent out there on Facebook and to all those who are going to listen to Road Download. We are all downloaders of the glory of God. We are all downloaders of the words of God, the revelation of God. Hi, good morning. Good morning, Jess. Good morning, Karma Band. This is Nancy in Florida, and I am outside because of my signal, but I'd like to show you how the sun is beautiful today. Hey, Sarah, good morning. Good morning to my mom and Mong, and thank you for joining me with Road Download, and especially those who are in the Philippines, I know. And I'm going to try to go back in my car because it's really cold. I just want to try to get a signal because the signal in my car is not so good. But I want to make sure that you all can see me and be with you. Thank you so much. I just want to let you know how much I love you all. I love you all with the love of God. And the love that I feel for you, for all of you, is that brotherly love, agape, unconditional love, not just the paleo love. But it's the love of God, that we are all one and the same in Him. And when I see you, it gives me such joy. Good morning, Anthony. Good morning, my brother. We're going to have Road Download one time. It is time. It is due for another Road Download for you and me. Because last year, we did that together. And I will never forget, Brother Anthony, where you put on the shades and become really a downloader. And let me tell you, brother, you are such a powerful man. There's so much revelation in you. There is so much life giving words that's in the inside of you. Not just that, but it's who you are. It's who you are becoming in Christ. And to all those also who have been preaching and teaching and just passionately, relentlessly, tirelessly really preaching and teaching the gospel of the kingdom of God. How are you, Karma Ban Raulo? Thank you so much. I'm well. God bless you. And hello to Nat, my sister-in-law. Good morning. Good evening there in the Philippines. Good evening to my mom and my dad and my brothers, Brother Osmi and my brother Bernard and all my nieces. Thank you so much. I am so happy with this coming new year. I don't know how you feel and sense about New Year 2019. I felt lighter. I felt like we really have hopped into another year where God is doing more of His work for us. Where this is the year that we have the yoke of Christ in us. You know, let's take His yoke, for His yoke is light and easy. And so this is the year that I'm taking His yoke, because I want to walk light. I want to walk without burdens and baggages. It is time to really put them down, because our minds and our decision in life means a lot of either life or death. You know, the decisions we make is so important. And so today, you know, before I was going into Road Download, hello, Sister Pressy. I just felt the presence of God. And you know, when the presence of God is in you or with you, especially for women, it is hard to control the tears. I'm in Florida right now, Karma Ban. Thank you so much. I'm in Florida, USA. So sometimes it's hard to hold back the tears. And you have seen me in tears a couple of times in Road Download, and sometimes I just allow the Holy Spirit. But this morning, you know, I really felt how great God is. And I just want, before I share what God downloaded to me this morning, I would like to encourage you. Hi Merlin. Just to read a couple of verses in Psalm 83. as I was going to Starbucks, and I just want to share this with you. My Starbucks is here. I was driving through Starbucks and I had my Bible on my side because I was getting ready to see what I'm going to do in Road Download. The lady in Starbucks, the one who was handing me the coffee, asked me, because he saw through my car, he said, "Is that a Bible?" I said, "Yes, that is a Bible." And he said, "Wow, that's awesome. You know, what version is it?" And she asked me questions and I said, "Well, it's a New Translation version." And I showed my Bible to her, and then she asked me, she said that the Bible is her favorite book to read, so she asked me to look on a verse that's in her heart. It is on Psalm 83 verse 18. So I just want to share that with you, because when I read that, when we read on the Bible and fully our spiritual hearts and ears and eyes are open, it will just bring such transformation, such change in the inside of us, that it just will automatically shift you, shift your spirit and your soul, you know, for that day. So Psalm 83 verse 18. Hello everybody, I love you all. Good morning, good evening, wherever you are. Psalm 83 verse 18. And this is what's written on my Bible. It says, "Let them know that you, whose name is the Lord, that you alone are the Most High over all the earth." Now that's very powerful when I read that. That your name, that our God's name is the Lord. The Lord means owner. That He is the Most High. He owns everything, including us. So when we hear this word, when we hear about this message and the Bible, doesn't that humble you down? Doesn't that humble us down? Doesn't that make us want to go and bow on our knees before the Lord? Because we know that we are here on earth, and that we have someone mighty, almighty Father, almighty God in the heaven who owns everything. So He is the Most High over all the earth. If He is the Most High, we should also be confident being with the Most High. Thank you, Anthony. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You know, I mean, when I read that, there's just my spirit leaped. My spirit leaped that, wow, how blessed I am. And then I saw, and I keep reading it after she showed me that, but I kept reading on the verse, and here's what it says, that blessed are those, this is now in Psalm 84, 4, blessed are those who dwell in your house. They are ever praising you. Wow. And we are the dwelling of God. We are the dwelling of God. We are the dwelling of the Father, as we also dwell with Him. So in that mode of God dwelling in us and us dwelling in Him, it says here, they are ever praising you, ever praising. That means that every day, every moment, there is a source, an eternal source of praising God. Eternal source of just thanking God. It will never dry out and it will never run out, because the Father, the Spirit of the Father, is a spring. In the morning, in the night, it's always springing, and it's fresh in the morning. So whenever we need that strength, it is of the Father who gives us that strength and praise. And it says here in verse 5, Psalm 84, "Blessed are those whose strength is in you, and who have set their hearts on the pilgrimage." And then at the very end of 84, it says, "O Lord Almighty, blessed is the man who trusts in you." Blessed is the man who trusts in you. That's why we can say, those who are trusting in the Lord, those who are believing in the Lord, we are blessed. We are blessed. The measure of being blessed here is not about the financial situation. It's not about the situation in our lives that we encounter here in this world. The blessed meaning here is that we trust in the Lord. That when we trust in the Lord, we are blessed. Why? Because there is an outcome of trusting in the Lord. The outcome is peace. The outcome is joy. The outcome is everlasting praises, everlasting thankfulness. We should be, you know, people should be looking at us that there is an almost infinite, overflowing, non-stop smile, non-stop joy, non-stop use of our zygomatic muscles, non-stop flickering and sparkling in our eyes, non-stop glow in our spirit, non-stop glow in the way we walk. And I want to be that. We want to be that. Like God, it doesn't matter how others think about us. Thank you, Mom. Thank you, Mama. And good morning, Alva. And no matter how others think about us, don't think about what others gonna say to us or think about us. What's important is what the Father thinks of us and what we're doing for the Father and how we are for the Father. So even if you are on the road and you know you're just singing, you're laughing, you're smiling, and you're just carrying, you're carrying that presence of God in us, because we're continually dwelling in Him. And it says, I'm gonna say this again in the verse, that Psalm 84 verse 4, blessed are those who dwell in your house, they are ever praising you. Wow, ever praising you. I'm saying, God, I'm sorry, forgive me, you know, forgive me, oh Lord, for my trespasses, that there are times in my life that I was not praising you, that there are times in my life that I'm bitter, that there are times in my life that I feel down, that there are times in my life that I can't open my mouth to give praise and thanks to you. Forgive me, Father, for those situations that I could not. Forgive me, Father, for the time of weakness where I am drawn by the flesh and the carnal nature of my mind and my soul to where it draws me away from your presence. Forgive me, Father God, for those moments and times in my life that I have forgotten to uplift your name, that I have missed on trusting you. Forgive me, Father, for not believing the words and losing that power that you have given unto me, the power that I know that power is in me is through you. That forgive me, Father God, that I'm not able to smile to my neighbors today. Forgive me, Father God, that I didn't say a life-giving word to the driver next to me on the road today. Forgive me, Father God, for the people I encounter in the supermarket that I didn't ask them to if I can help them, Father God. Forgive me, Father God, for the family that I have hurt today. Forgive me for saying things that are not of life that hurt people. Forgive me, Lord, for all these things that I have done without thinking about you in my life. That God, help me to be always conscious, to be always mindful that you are my dwelling place and that you are dwelling in me, that I am a carrier of that heavenly culture, that I am a carrier of your presence, that I would like for everything that comes out of me will be a blessing to everybody, that will be what you want me to be, that it will give them life. Forgive me, O Lord, for being this nature that I have, that I'm still struggling, that I'm still battling this carnal flesh, these thoughts that I didn't even want to think, Lord God. They just come to my thoughts, and Father God, forgive me. Forgive me for being selfish, for thinking about just myself. Forgive me, Lord, that I am thinking about my own self, what I'm going to have, what I'm going to eat, what I'm going to do. Forgive me, Father God, that I am lacking on thinking of others much more so than myself, because you said that whoever trusts in you is blessed, and I am trusting you, Father God. So I am blessed that when I fully trust you, nothing can go against me, Father, that everything that you say will come to pass, because your words are true, and your words are not a man that would lie, that your words are powerful. Forgive us, O Lord, for all these things as children of God. And hello, Antoinette Pangan, thank you so much for coming in. And I just want to lift up every children of God. I want to lift up to the Father today, all of us, the body of Christ, the sons of God, the citizens of God, that Father God, we bow down before you. Lord, forgive us. pour more mercy upon us. We need more mercy than those who do not know about you, Father God. For those who are us, who knows mercy and love, who knows about compassionate, are not able to practice it. We are more poor right now because we're not practicing what we know. But those who doesn't have the knowledge of you, God, forgive us, O Lord, that they have a reason not to show mercy. They have a reason not to be kind. They have a reason not to forgive because they don't know you, Father God. But us who are your children, Lord God, forgive us, O Lord. Lord, we are humbled. We are ashamed. We are ashamed and embarrassed, Father God, that we're saying we're your child and we're your sons of God. But in us, others are not seeing it through us, that we fall short. We fall short, Father God, to become what you want us to be and what you have given us. You have given us life. You have given us your love. So we're the ones, Father God, that we need more strength. We need more power. We need more of you, Lord, to help us to go up to the level of who you are, to meet up to the level of your character and nature, Lord, that we meet up to the level of the righteousness that you want us to be as kingdom citizens. Oh, Father God, I pray for each one of us, my brothers and my sisters. Lord, I ask for that cleanliness. Cleanse our spirit and our hearts right now, Father God, with the blood of the Lamb, that we're going to be white as snow again, Father, and this today is a clean slate for us, that we're going to start anew and afresh, but by your words and your power and the Holy Spirit, that we're going to be much better than yesterday, much better than last year, because we are wanting to be up to the level of the above and of the heavenlies, because that's where we are from, that we want to be able to pour out in this earth what heavenly things are. So Father God, I pray for the whole body of Christ that you pour right now in every parts of the world, in every parts of the country, in the whole earth, in the whole world, that there will be a flowing, a release of a breath of life once again, Father God. Breathe life, that spirit life in every one of us, that we may become that fresh new son of you again, that we are being renewed today for a powerful day and for the next several days. Father God, we open our spirits right now. We lift up our hands unto you, that God, we receive you. We receive the new fresh breath today. Forgive us as we lay down everything before the foot of Jesus Christ and by the cross, that we are now taking the yoke of Jesus, which is light and easy, that we're going to learn of him, that we're not going to walk in our own, but we're going to walk in Christ. Thank you, Father God, for this new day. Thank you for the new mercy that we're receiving right now. Thank you, Lord, for everybody who's listening here on earth, here on Road Download right now. Thank you, Anita. Thank you, Anthony Young. Thank you so much that I am asking the Lord that let us believe. Let us believe, sons of God. Let us believe. Let's put our mind and our spirits. Think about all the nations right now. Think about all the people. Think about the whole earth. Be filled with the breath of life of God. Be filled with the presence of God in the whole world. And it's a whole system that all darkness will fade away. Darkness has faded away. That as we see in our vision and as we manifest, as we proclaim that now the whole world is in light, that there's no darkness, there's no taint, there's no stain of sin, there's no blood stains anymore in the hearts and the spirit of all this world. Father God, we worship you, we bless you, we worship you, and we bow down, and we ask, Father God, that you release right now, release your hands in all over the earth, in all the systems, and in all your children, that we be come light, that we will reflect your light. We are your reflectors, Father God. Make us shine. Smooth us. Smooth our spirit, Lord God. Wipe us clean so that when you reflect your light to us, it will reflect to other people and see your goodness and see your light. Oh, Lord God, help us to clean our own lives today, that we will hear you, we will follow you, that we will only do what you say for us to do, that no other than that. But whatever is written in your word is what we're going to do, and not just say it and not just talk about it, but walk of it. We're going to want to walk right now, God, according to your will, for there is no other will. Lord, there is no other way. We know there's no other path. There's no other road but the road that you lead us to. And that's where we all want it to be, Lord God. Put your mercy upon us. The grace, oh God, let it pour. Let it multiply that we can be much greater for the next few hours, the next few days, and this week, for your glory alone. For your glory alone, Father God. Thank you so much, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you right now, God, for I know and I see what's declared and what's released in the atmosphere by all of you on road download and here right now and the road download in my car. For I know and I believe that what we have spoken has come to pass. So now let us believe, let us receive, and let us trust God, and let us walk. Let us walk in what was proclaimed, because there is power in the words that we speak. There is power that's in Christ, that who is in us is greater than this world. So you and I, as children of God, continue to carry that torch. Lift up your feeble hands and lift up your feeble knees. Your weak hands, lift them up. Continue to lift them up as the Lord will uphold your hand, as the Lord will straighten our knees so that we can stand firm and continue to hold the torch of the presence of God, the torch of the mighty God, the torch of the Lord who is the Almighty all over the earth. Thank you, Father God, as I see a lot of lights coming on right now, that we have cleaned the atmosphere, that these words we speak penetrate and be transcending to time and to the atmosphere and to the airwaves. Thank you so much. Thank you, Father God. Thank you so much for that cleanliness right now. And as we start anew, I give praise and honor and glory to you. For you alone, Father God, is worthy of all our praise. As we trust in you, we pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Holy Spirit, thank you right now for being with us on Road Download. In Jesus' name I pray and I declare and decree all of this in your name and through our faith in you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Glory to God. Wow. Okay, I just have 5 minutes left, and but thank you so much for every one of you who are here right now. I was going to share something, what God has downloaded to me, and I ended up just, you know how it is when God starts downloading with you, he just tells you what to do and what to say and to pray. But let me just give you the tidbits of this. Let me see. Hi, Vito. Good morning. Good morning to you. I'm going to leave in a few minutes, but this is what I want you to read. When I'm gone here on Road Download, look in Matthew, go to Matthew 21 verses 28. Go look on Matthew 21 verses 28 to 30. Okay. Matthew 21 verses 28 to 30. That is about the parable of the two sons. And let me go ahead quickly in 4 minutes, and I want to summarize this. The parable of the two sons. This is where I'm going to read it. What do you think? There was a man who had two sons. He went to the first son and said, "Son, go and work today in the vineyard." "I will not," he answered. But later he changed his mind and went. Then the father went to the second son and said the same thing. He answered, "I will, sir," but he did not go. See, there are two sons here that he has mentioned for them to go to the vineyard. One son said, "I will go." The second son said, "I won't go." So, you know, this is a long parable, but I'm going to make it short. That sometimes, you know what it is in 1 Corinthians, that the kingdom of God is not of talk, that the kingdom of God is of power. But I'm not saying that the talk has no power, because our words, the words we speak, our tongue causes life and death. The power of our tongue is life and death. So there is power in the words that we speak. There is life and death. But at the same time, whatever we have spoken, If you have spoken death to someone, if you have spoken something bad to someone, there is what you call repentance, changing our minds. And that's how gracious and good our God is. He gives us this grace so that we can change and repent our mind and do what is right. So this second son, or the first son, changed his mind. He repented. He repented and did what the father say. So which is more, who is more effective? The one who walked and did what he said he will not do become more effective in the kingdom of God. But the one who said, I will do it, but did not do it, was not pleasing to God. So what I want to try to say here is that we can talk a lot, we can speak a lot, we can share a lot. And I'm not saying this is, you know, I am perfect myself. I do a lot of talking, but I may not be doing a lot of walking. But it is time. It is time, and the Lord is waiting for us to walk, not just to talk. The God is waiting for us to walk what we talk. And if we are misaligning, if we miss the mark to walk the talk, repent. We have a chance to repent and correct that and still go and do what is right. God is looking for the workers, the doers. God is not looking just for the hearers. God is looking for the doers and the walkers. And so now we are in that stage of this 2019. It is time for us to walk. Sometimes it's better not to say a thing and not do it. Integrity is very important with God. Integrity, when you say something, be careful. And that is what I'm doing right now. I'm being careful to what I say. That whatever I say, I have a responsibility and accountability to the words I speak. So be careful not to speak too much, for that what you said will come back to you. For what that you said can bring life or death. So it's better for a wise man who is silent. A wise man can be silent. Even the fools that are silent can be considered as wise, because we should not be hasty with our words, but we should be quick to listen. We should not be hasty with what we say, but make sure we walk what we say. And I know I fall short with that as well. I'm not saying I walk the talk all the time. Hey, I fall short as well, because I have my own battle and struggle in the inside of me, that I have my flesh, I have my ego, I have all these selfish things. And so sometimes I do the talk and not walking it. And last thing I want to say, on Ecclesiastes 7 verse 8, it says, the end of the matter is better than its beginning. The end of the matter is better than its beginning. So if you entered 2019 and if you felt like you blew it, you felt like, man, I messed up already. I said I was going to do this and now I can't do it anymore. I thought I started well. But here it is, Ecclesiastes 7:8. The end of the matter is better than its beginning. Keep pushing, keep pressing, keep doing it. It's not over yet. Keep going on. Do what you're supposed to do, because the end of the beginning, the outcome, is better than how you started. Since you have started, what's important is you have started what your goal is in life. You have started what God wants you to do. But keep pressing. Keep doing. However it may look to others, however it may feel to you, it is not over yet. The end of the matter is better than its beginning. So let's keep on going. To all those people who are Leaning Road download, yes, good morning, Ray. I am so blessed. Good evening in the Philippines. So blessed to see you again with the Kingdom Walk. And so good to see the beautiful view in the Philippines. So begin. You already have begun. We're not going to say we're beginning. We have begun. But if we fall short, let's get up and start again and keep on pressing. Because whatever you see at the end of 2019, that is your target. That is the target. And no matter how you get to your target, no matter how you get there, no matter how long you get there, as long as you get to the target, you are a winner. And you already are a winner in Christ. Because God's going to give you all the strength and the power. And when you trust in Him, He will definitely and for surely take you on to your target in 2019. Thank you so much. I love you all. I wish I had more time, and I know my mom will say this is short, but I have work to do. So I will see you again next week. Road download. Thank you, Alva. I love you, sister. I love you, Anita. I love you, Anthony. I love you, Ray. I love you, Mom. I love you, Carmadan. I love you, Vito. I love you, Jess. I love everybody. God's love. Let's share God's love. Love is everywhere. And love is the answer to evil. Love overcomes evil. If there's evil around you, bring out the love. If there's chaos around you, bring out the love. That is our weapon. That is our weapon and power, not just to stop the evil, but to convert the evil unto good. That's the power of love in God. Not just suppressing the flame and the anger of a fire from someone else, but transfer that and transform that into much more love. So thank you so much. I love you all. I have got to go. Yes. Thank you, God. Thank you, Mang and Pang and Ray. Thank you so much. God bless you. And say hello to your family. Awesome wedding and pictures you have. And Alva, I love you. Anthony Young, yes. Anthony, you got to get back with me. We're going to have to do road download again next time. And Alva, I love you. Hi, Chris. Yes, above all things, deeply, but love covers over multitudes of sins. Amen. I love you, Chris. And I know whoever else is going to watch this. Please share if you'd like to share this video. It will be great for other people to hear about our Father, about the kingdom, about Christ. And it is our daily reward that we are in His presence and covered with the Holy Spirit all the time. Love you all. God bless you. Bye for now.